parts of speech in English, explained and narrated by Krishna Das, KD.
Definition of parts of speech in English. The part of speech in English indicates how the word functions in meaning as well as grammatically within the sentence. The parts of speech are the basis of English. Now we will see the classification of the parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech in English. They are noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. Remember, there are 8 parts of speech. Now let's see what are nouns. Nouns are naming words that name a person, place, animal or thing, and even emotions. Now we will see the classification of nouns. There are 4 basic types of nouns. They are proper nouns, common nouns, collective nouns, and abstract noun. Apart from this, there are also material noun, but ultimately it comes under common noun only. So these types of nouns you should keep in mind: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and abstract noun. Now let's see what are pronouns, the words which are used in place of nouns are called pronouns. For example, he, she, they, myself, us, etc. Apart from this, there are many types of pronouns which we use in our everyday life. Here we can see Jack and Millie came to tea. Here Jack is he and Millie is she, male and female. Now see what is a verb. All of you know what is a verb. Verb is an action word. Whatever we do, those are actions. All of we do many types of work every day, like sleep, run, speak, standing, driving, playing, all are verbs. Verbs display our action. Each and every action represent verbs. Verbs is very important part of speech. Now we are going to learn about adjectives. Now let's see what are adjectives. Adjectives are describing words which describe a noun or a pronoun. Different types of adjectives are, for example, tall, short, long, fat, thin, or adjective. We can learn adjective with this adjective strong. An adjective can tell us more about a noun, color, shape, and size, its texture, and its sound. To make our creative writing more lively and more good, we should use proper adjective to describe anything, even human behavior. adjectives make our creative writing more lively and it reads more fantastic. Adjectives can be used to describe human behavior or the shape or size of any objects or to describe any scenario or to describe any monument or to describe anybody's mood. We can use adjective for every person, for everything, for every object. We have proper adjective. We only have to know how to use proper adjectives while writing our creativity. In letter writing and in essay and in paragraph, we need lots of adjectives. So we should have proper vocabulary of adjective. Now we will see the next parts of speech, that is adverb. Now let's define what an adverb is. An adverb describe an adverb and a verb. That means how an action is taken. It also describe another adverb, that how the action is taken place. An adverb also describe an adjective. It denotes either something special about an adjective or another adverb and also a verb. It tells us how the action has been done. It says something about another adverb and it also describes adjective. These are some common example of adjective which we use. If we feel difficult in understanding adverb, we can go through this easy question. How the action has taken place? How much the adjective is? Where the action taken place? How often the action taken place? And when the action taken place? If we go through this part, we can easily understand what an adverb is. There are certain rules to change an adjective or a verb into adverb. We should keep these rules in of grammar in our mind. Now, let's define another part of speech, that is preposition. A preposition is a word used to link nouns, pronouns, or phrases to other words within a sentence. Preposition is very helpful to us in English. Here in this picture, we can see some of the common used preposition. You can see the position of the joker and you can find out what a preposition and when we should use a proper preposition. Like behind, between, under, in, on, they are all prepositions. We can also see here different positions of preposition, like in, on, at, under, between, above, below. All these are prepositions. With the help of this picture clip, we can easily understand the use of how to put the preposition in the correct word. This picture shows us where to use the preposition and how to use the preposition properly. Preposition is very difficult to understand. We should use this picture wisely. There are certain prepositions which are used in groups. These are called prepositional phrases. Here, certain preposition phrases are given which we should use in our daily life. Prepositions are very important in English. While writing anything, we use proper use of preposition. Now let's see what is a conjunction. Conjunction is a part of speech that connects two words, sentences, phrases, or clauses. Here, the example of conjunction, which are joining words, are given here. Conjunction are especially joining phrases or words. These are the examples of conjunction, like because, when, so, but, and, then. These are conjunction. There are many conjunction apart from this. There are different types of conjunction. Here we can see it. Coordinating conjunction, subordinating conjunction, and co-relative conjunction. To understand it well, we should go through the example and definition given in this picture. Conjunctions are joining words which are divided into three parts: coordinating, subordinating, and co-related. Sometimes a preposition and a conjunction, they seem to look alike, but we should know the proper difference between a preposition and conjunction. Now let's define the last part of speech, that is interjection. An interjection is a word or phrase that reveals a sudden feeling or emotion of the speaker. Here are some examples of interjection, like wow, hey, hooray, wait, yippee, oh, no, yay, ouch, Alice. All these are different types of interjection, mean sudden feeling. Interjection. Here some interjection has been given with the sentence along with them. If we read out the sentences here and try to see how these interjections have been used in a sentence, we can understand the proper use of interjection here. These are some sentences and the list of or the examples of interjection here. I hope you have understand the parts of speech.